hello everybody and welcome back. I hope you all have had a great Friday so far and are looking forward to the weekend. Before we get started with Gotham Knights, as you can see here in the little corner right here. Before we get started with that, just a quick reminder. Linktree/CrimsonKnight, patreon.com/CrimsonKnight. Those are the places you can find me. Linktree will take you to everywhere that you can find me. And the Patreon is where you can support me if you so choose. If not, it's okay. It's, you know, NBD. Yeah. Anyway. Do I have anything else I want to say? I said it earlier this week. I'm planning on taking a vacation, a week off or so, at some point. And some point in the next month. Oops. I did not mute my phone. But yeah, I plan on taking some time off, about a week off or so, sometime this month. I have not nailed down exactly when, but I will let you all know through my social medias, which you can find in the link tree. You know, the link tree. God, I'm sorry. I'll let you know, you guys know through my socials and my Discord, what's going on with that. Or you can check the, or if you're watching me on Twitch, there's the channel schedule and stuff. I keep that up to date. So that should be, you know, fine and dandy and good. We're not going to have science tonight, at least not for another hour or so. It depends on how busy he is. He said he'll pop in if he's able to. But if not, that's okay. Yeah. Anyway, let's get back on into it. So, brief little updates, just a quick reminders of things. We have
apart and sent to the GCPD evidence locker
because they have such outstanding security.
The League of Assassins have kind of gone hog wild on Gotham after killing off, Jacob Kane, who is the leader of the Court of Owls. We're going to be heading to Arkham at some point. I almost said to Gotham. Derp, derp. I wonder what everybody's doing upstairs. Off.
Keep an eye on it. It is Harley's Haven, after all.
She's the one who told him about Bruce. You know that, right?
You think so?
No doubt. We'll need to keep an eye on both of them.
But, yeah, he's over here playing the game. Tim's just chilling. Oh, Alfred taking care of the plants. All right. I wonder what Barbara would be doing. Let me swap to Dick.
Let me get some Dick in here.
Actually, before we do that, just want to point out, excuse me. The abilities for, actually, no, I should go through them all. We'll start with him. Monsieur Red Hood. So we had the adorable moment with him and the gang in the kitchen. I currently have him wearing legendary gear. A whole set of legendary. You know. Which is why he's wearing this rather than his, the Nightwatch suit. We have all of his momentum abilities unlocked. I worked with science and was, and we ground some of those out so that he's able to, so that he was able to get them all done. We do have emails that I need to check, but not yet. Um, there was a training area thing that we did that I did after that, after getting that final ability unlocked. That's Red Hood. Pop over to Robin. We have all of his momentum abilities unlocked, as you can see here. And he may not be, he's not fully in legendary gear. As you can see here, he's, but he does have a legendary ranged thing. Does not have the ability to craft anything legendary at the moment, which is why he's still in his Nightwatch outfit. I decided to put him back into it after deciding legendary would be, a better marker for changing of outfit than, epic. Anyway, so that completed his family thing, which was the chess match with Alfred, where he took Bruce's chess set and gave it to Alfred. Now you may notice something different about Nightwing. The Nightwing suit is not the Nightwatch one, as you can see by looking at it. It is instead the one for this suit. And that's because while I don't have him in complete legendary gear, his suit is legendary. And so that's why I decided to do things, do things that way. So yeah, he is in his, I don't remember now, Titan suit. With the Tribute Asylum colorway, just so you're aware. I used the Tribute Asylum because I didn't care for some of the other ones. Like, This one felt too light, so I went with Tribute Asylum, you know. And here are the other cowls options. I wasn't feeling any of them, so I went with that one. Which is generally my preferred Nightwing mask anyway. I like the way it curves up and down like a bat on his face. The symbol options were this, this, or this. I like the solid one. The gloves, we had this one, or this one. Honestly, Nightwing, it felt, I'm torn. I went with this because these two were the same one, you know? But like, it does make sense for him to have some kind of like technology on his forearms because armor, but also like it allows him to interact with like, you know, the computer and shit like that, because that's canonically what they do. This felt more lightweight and thus, you know, whatever. With the boots, we have that or that. Or that. And this one I liked because it makes the whole suit a little bit feel a little bit more together, as one piece, as opposed to that, you know? Like, I like that, that one better. And that's one of the reasons why I went with the, I don't know. I guess I'll go with that, actually. I don't hate that. Don't exactly hate that. No, I like the other one better. I like that one better. Yeah, there we go. There we go. Anyway, so, yeah. Oh, and abilities, yes. Momentum. We have all of his momentum abilities unlocked, as you can see here. So that's Red Hood, Nightwing, and Tim. And that just leaves Bats. Bats, Babs, Batgirl, who is the one who has not gotten all of her momentum abilities. As you can see here, there's this one that needs unlocked, got a little padlock on it, and this one needs to be unlocked as well. This one I have to complete her story mission over here at the Gordon Memorial. Couldn't do that last time because both she and Dick had ones out in the field. So I went with Grayson instead of her. But we'll go with her today. Her gear, she's got legendary weapons and equipment and stuff, but she doesn't have a legendary suit yet. Doesn't even have one craftable yet, as you can see here. So basically she's going to be the one we're going to be running around as today, for the most part, at least for right off the bat. The bat. yeah, before we do that, let's go through emails. Let's start with her. To all from Tim regarding Lazarus research. I'm looking into this. I like a project, sue me. And I noticed something interesting in the way Raish had staggered his exposure to the Lazarus pits. They started out much further apart than they were at the time he died. He would go years between dips when he and Bruce first crossed paths. But as time went on, they increased in frequency until he was doing it multiple times a year. I wondered if maybe this had something to do with the weakening impact upon repeat exposures, but I was wrong. In fact, the opposite is true. The opposite is true. As I mentioned previously regarding compound effects, it also doesn't seem to be tied to an increasing frequency of mortal wounds. Judging from everything I've read, Raish must have avoided exposing himself to the effects of the Lazarus Pit too frequently due to some kind of restoration period. We've seen with Jason that the side effects, while still present, have subsided substantially in many cases. If you make repeated trips before said restoration period, though, those side effects get worse and last longer. And even those get worse the shorter the periods between visits. By the end, based on how often Raish was exposing himself, I'm surprised he wasn't completely feral. No wonder Bruce was so concerned about the waters of the Lazarus Pit. They're incredibly dangerous. Next email regarding the Lazarus research from Tim to all. How much of her father was left in there is exactly it. We've all heard Bruce talk about the League of Shadows and their mission statement of raising cities to allow rebirth. Raish used to believe that in a very genuine way, but as time went on, the mission itself fell by the wayside, and Raish was less concerned with the rebirth part of the equation. The untrained eye might chalk that up to a would-be dictator who got bored with the facade of a noble cause, but exposure to the Lazarus Pit affects your mind. Rage-induced mood swings and a degradation of morality are known side effects of exposure, in addition to extensive memory loss that we've seen in Jason. With enough exposure, those side effects just keep getting worse. If you weren't careful, it could literally turn you into a different person. In fact, several of Bruce's logs refer to Raish as having a fury about him during later confrontations that was absent from previous ones. The fact that Talia wasn't just willing to let her father die, but pushed him into the incinerator herself, could partly be the side effects of the Lazarus taking hold as well. Interesting. It's talking like they're wanting to, like they're leading towards resurrecting Bruce. I hope not, because that's the last thing Bruce would ever want to, or would ever allow to happen. There we go. Emails. Okay, so those were the only emails right there. Yeah, yep, Yep. Okay. No. Yeah. No. That one. There we go. All right. Do we have anything else we want to do before we head out? Challenges. All right. Crafting. Shinobi suit. Legendary bio. Not there. Criminal strongholds and witness under attack crimes and an owl's nest. Okay. Is right there. And yeah. So we'll hit here first. So the plan is we'll complete Barbara's story. And then we will visit Montoya. Probably Lucius and the watch. Collect those missions and then come down here and start down here. That's what we'll do. All right. Now, we do technically have Basil Carlo here to worry about. And that's actually a point. Let me look at this. Hold on. So 23, 26. I could do it now, or I could wait. Ooh. No, let's do it. Let's not do it now. Oh, wait. Oh, I was going to check to see where Babs was upstairs. What she was doing. While the others were running. Well, the others were. Get off the geometry. Oh, there she is. At the library. Aw, look at her. All right. All right, allons-y. All right. Do my story.
Oh.
Damn, girl, your cape is going crazy. Oh. Barbara, 12th birthday in Robinson Park. This game is gonna make me cry, I swear to God. Alright, so what was the thing I just got? Defeat enemies using my drone. Okay, can do, or at least I will try. Oh, I know what it unlocked. It unlocked her version of the tribute colors. Right. All right, abilities. All right. Oh, a bat swarm. Yes. Okay. All right. Now then. Hey Montoya, let's talk.
My night just got interesting. Good to see you, Batgirl.
Detective Montoya, I trust that we'll be sticking to our professional names in public.
Of course. I'd never live it down if people knew I didn't figure it out on my own. Because of you, another honest cop got to come home after their shift.
Never live it down if I didn't figure it out on my own. Alright.
Thanks for keeping an eye out for us.
Now. Start up here.
Oh my. I have some new intel. All
right. Talucius, ow. Weird. I didn't mean to do that. Oh well.
Huh.
I have got to install better cameras up here.
All right, what's he want? Legendary suit, melee, or ranged weapon. Legendary mod ship. Oh, interesting. Okay. But you can craft legendary mod ships using mod fusion. Science and I were struggling trying to figure it out because we could not, for the life of us, figure out how. Because if we just tried using the epics, they would just come out with more epics. Interesting. So I'm gonna need to try to figure out how to do that. Let's see here, who's next? Seems to be it. So let's go to the Owl's Nest. This will be her last Owl's Nest needed, which will unlock one of her abilities. Wrong way.
This has court written all over.
Using the key that they got earlier, she unlocked the door. And moved inside. Oh, I'm not gonna. Well, I might. Oops. Well, I got some of them. I'll take it.
Joffrey, I just cleared out one of the quartz nests.
Adrenaline search. All right, real quick, let's see what that ability is. Adrenaline search. Increases Batgirl's damage, critical chance, critical damage, and defense by 20%. And the effect, elemental effect build up by 50% for 12 seconds. Nice. Okay. What gear did I get? Anything legendary? Do I already have a legendary talent? I do. And a legendary batarang, right? Right, okay. All right. Now, let's just head to these for now. No, not that one. Oh no, a trap. Damn. All right, come on, fuckers. Let's go. Hi, y'all. Oops. All right, that only did us two, right? Oh, one, not even two. All right. All right, let's see here. What we got, what we got, what we got, what we got. All right, we have owl presence and we have regulator presence down here. We have organ trafficking. What are my contacts wanting? Corrupt GCPD, stop crimes, very high difficulty. Criminal strongholds. Do I have any of those? Criminal stronghold, witness under attack, kidnapping in progress, armored truck robbery, armed robbery, robbery, officers under attack, criminal stronghold, hey, okay, all right, so we do have a criminal stronghold, we'll get to that, contact. Witness under attack crimes, we have one of those. Those are going to be kind of hard to do. The watch, what does the watch want? Stop crimes in North Gotham, easy peasy. Inspire North Gotham, use momentum abilities to defeat criminals in North Gotham, easy peasy.
Lemon squeezy.
I'm not sorry. All right, damn it, wrong button. All right, lettuce leaf. Let's focus on the reds for now.
Hmm.
around here.
Come on. There you go.
Who knows what they'll do if they spot me? Better be careful. Bingo.
All right. Lucky. They're not looking at me, so I'm just gonna... Come on. Ooh! Damn, girl. Get it, girl. Oops, wrong button.
Valkyrie, this won't last long outside of cold storage.
Dr. Tompkins is on her way to the drop site. Meet with her and she'll handle it.
I would be triggering the drone, but I don't have the time because I have 13 seconds. Damn it. Well, the organ's about to expire. I don't have time for this. I have to complete the witness under attack. The organ's gonna fail. Yep.
Not today, bad guy.
All right. The only reason that was a problem at all is because this was a red. It was a red, and once you go into the areas of the reds and activate them, yeah. You have to complete them or you automatically fail, basically. That's frustrating. Oh well, but did I get the... proof. Okay, that works. Alright. I was looking for challenges. Nope. Contacts. There we go. Oh, this, it had to be a very high difficulty. Fine. Alright. Well, apparently that one wasn't. Alright. Oh well, oh well, oh well. I tried. Kidnapping in progress. Care of that. How about you throw that in the right direction, bitch? God damn.
Thank you for helping me.
Get home safe.
All right.
Units needed at Star City Bank, Atlantic and Prince. Robbery in progress.
need to step up your game. Have to get out of here.
Working on it. Collecting loot. Alright. Now then. Skylight. Alright. Okay. Normal criminal stronghold. What do you think, Penguin? Is that good enough for your ass? Normal or higher? Hell yeah. Alright. So that's where we'll go next.
here and try to be quiet.
Breath. Girl, there you go.
You should be safe now. Aw, they're almost cute when they're sleeping.
Alright, so that puts me up to 6. Not bad. To do that,
down.
Paramedics are inbound.
Damn it, come on. Thank you.
now. Crap.
Bitch, go over the damn railing! Come on. There we go. Okay. Prison transport attack, armed robbery attack. All right. Probably we're not doing very good. Yeah. Even though, I'm so mad because I got them all down to like orange, but okay. We're okay. Slightly annoyed. All right. Thank you. All right, well, where's their healer? There she is. Okay. Why the hell are you two coming at me? Knock myself on the ass. Alright. That's all of that. Yeah, let's go talk to Penguin. Might as well. Okay. Oh my god, seriously? Okay. Now, the red's taken care of. 35. No. We're gonna this now. Here we go back to Arkham Asylum. Huh. I feel like they did a decent job mimicking.
Alfrey, approaching Arkham.
Received. Keep us updated.
Mimicking, but keeping it distinctly different from the Arkham Asylum of the Arkham series. Like, it's obvious that
in the abandoned asylum. Great.
Yeah. What's over here? But yeah, it's obvious that they did a good job, is what I'm trying to say.
This place is a ruin.
Yeah. Like, it's old as shit.
Angle here. She'd never leave things behind otherwise.
Have we talked about how maybe it has to do with the fact that Bruce's grave is not that far away? And despite everything, she did actually kind of love him. Hold on. I know we're really far into this for me to suddenly realize, oh shit, my camera is not in a good, convenient location for this game. But, you know, what it is. Well, not. A little bit higher. There we go.
Was here. Where did they go?
I'm gonna bet the containment pod has Bruce in it.
Me of Langstrom's back at Gotham U.
Bet it's got Bruce in it.
some tank here? It looks familiar.
Whoa, that's Langstrom's research.
So Langstrom was working for the League, and now Talia's picked up where he left off.
Alright.
Did Langstrom or Talia work in these conditions?
Test subject photos. Photos of test subjects spanning from the earliest days of Langstrom's research to the present. Images indicate an escalation in brutality, likely from Talia al Ghul's most recent involvement. Physical performance reports. Physical trials of various volunteers showing a wide range of results. Volunteer N01 appears to have developed increased strength to a startling degree, but succumbed to further trials.
These serums are clearly Langstrom's handiwork.
Serum V23.06, Chiroptera DNA sequence 6, solution components gene recomposer, Dionysium 60%. Label is largely illegible. All right. Concentration of gene recomposer used here is at a significantly higher percentage than the other serums. Notably low Dionysium compared to the other serums. This formula includes an extra component labeled L. The combination of substances makes it difficult to separate and define which component with each component without a proper lab analysis. 70% is significant concentration of Dionysium and likely caused extreme effects in volunteers, possibly even severe illness or sudden death. Mixture inside vial is especially high in Dionysium. Chiroptera DNA sequence 15, solution components, gene recomposer group M, 5%. Component Y is 10, component Z is 5, Dionysium 80%. Volunteers injected with V2-2407. That's this one. Okay. Only one survived. Notes detailing. Come on.
Why do people keep volunteering for this crap?
Because they want to live forever, and they probably get paid handsomely. Notes detailing experimental trials. They appear to be written by Talia al Ghul in Tamazite, which I believe is the language of the League. Heat text within translates to, Langstrom was too focused on the Dionysium. It is well water. It held back the potential of these brave tributes, but I have the key, a new formula to unlock a new potential. Let me guess, Lazarus. Talia's kunai.
Playing with genetic markers. I hate to think what that could mean.
Group L volunteer died after his trial scrambled their DNA. Strength 100%, cognitive performance 100%. Group N had double the physical strength. Group M survived the sonic tests after repeated resuscitation. and they had high cognitive performance and physical strength. And group O. Was pushed to the highest point of human potential, but the trial resulted in severely decreased intelligence. Okay. How did Talia advance Langstrom's research? Talia added an unnamed component unique to this serum with minimal Dionysium. And what was Talia trying to achieve? M survived.
Langstrom's method and ran with it using League volunteers. Subjects showed increased strength. I wonder how strong. They were conducting sonic tests in the tower here. But why? Downloading the data now. Belfry, we've lost power here.
Looking at the blueprints, your best bet's a panel in the basement through an old Mac security wing.
Of course it's through the Mac security wing. What else would it be? And of course it's in the basement. Mac security wing is absolutely where they're... Oh, God. Where they kept the likes of the Joker and whatnot. The administration. Probably... up his ear or not. Oh. Ah. Through here, maybe.
I forwarded you some data from the lab, whatever I could get before losing power. Take a look and let me know if you find anything we can use.
Received. We'll get right on it.
This particular equipment hasn't been operational for a long time. Electroconvulsive therapy was commonly prescribed for a wide range of mental and neurological disorders, but the practice fell out of broad use after some high-profile cases of abuse. Arkham Asylum was never exactly known for its medical ethics, and there's plenty of evidence of doctors and staff misapplying therapeutic techniques to degrade and control patients. Institutional abuses of power such as this were overlooked in various GCPD investigations. Yeah. Oop, there's something purple in here. Okay, esquisse. A prescription by Dr. Wilkins for Roland Desmond. Clinical trials at Arkham allegedly occur on a voluntary basis, with patients opting into experimental medicines if they respond poorly to traditional prescriptions. The most recent records indicate a staggering 84% of Gotham inmates signed a liability waiver while accepting untested treatments. Multiple patient signatures, quote unquote, are a complete match to the writing on this prescription. The paper's damage makes it impossible to know which experimental drugs Dr. Wilkins recommended for Desmond or how long he'd been forced to take them. There's a book down there.
It's amazing how much was just left behind.
Well, when you're being shut down, you're being shut down. Visitor's log. An Arkham Asylum visitor's log dated several years ago. Employees, visitors, cops, state and city officials were required to sign the visitor's log upon entering Arkham's grounds. Notable names from this one busy Wednesday include Aaron Cash, Dr. Hugo Strange, Dr. Harlene Quinzel, Dr. Wilkins, Detective Jim Gordon, various officials from the mayor's office, and metahuman specialist Dr. Victoria October. I believe over half of those names are from the comics, but I don't remember for sure. I know obvious ones like Jim and Aaron Cash and whatnot, but anyway. At least I think Aaron's from the comics. Been a minute.
Coming here.
Intake procedure. Deteriorated checklist explaining safety procedures during inmate intake. The procedure checklist only has three legible items. Assess patient's personal medical needs, maintain restraints at all times, search inmate thoroughly for foreign objects, razor blades under the tongue, contraband concealed within shoes, etc. The rest of the form is illegible.
There's a such thing as ghosts, but also I'm scared of ghosts.
Just imagine all the inmates who died there.
Thanks! Exactly what I needed to hear.
Let's see if I can recognize any names on the thing. Jane Doe! If that's the same Jane Doe that's from the comics, I know that name. Laszlo Valentine. Or Valentine. Valentin? Whatever. Laszlo. I know the name Laszlo. That looks intentionally illegible. With that one and that one. You, however, are Waylon Jones, aka Killer Croc. There's Jane Doe again. Alright, let's see if I can't. Alright, so there is something in Laszlo Valentin's or Valentine's cell that I'll probably be able to open it in a moment. I know there are no ghosts. but in the same time, I'm scared of ghosts. All right, Waylon Jones, aka Killer Croc.
It smells awful in here.
All hail King Croc. Yep. Jane Doe.
They kept Gotham's most dangerous down here.
There is, oh God, hold on. I'm gonna try to get a zoom in on this. We've got, a bunch of driver's licenses. And a, what are you? Correctional services uniform.
Pig wasn't here.
Yep. Laszlo Valentine. Valentine. Poetry. When getting organs, do what you must do. Get them fresh, don't be afraid to cut through. Muscle and bone and tissue and sinew. Don't rush it, though. Think every decision through. Humans are perennially easy to subdue. Just make sure to gag them so they don't scream at you. Professor Pig, one of the worst. One of my least favorites. By which I mean one of the ones I dread. Not because he's scary or anything, just because I don't. He's a problem. Oh, I wonder why.
There are lights on in the tower. I guess the league doesn't like anyone poking around.
Arms up, then.
The league's definitely here, and they weren't exactly happy to see me.
Good. It means we're on the right track.
Come on, get off the geometry. There you go. I'm so mad at myself because I only just now realized that the damn camera was blocking my momentum abilities. I'm so sorry, everybody. This is fucking episode goddamn 13.
There must be a way up to the tower.
You know, I would get the rest of that information from the computer.
Looks like they ran power cables up to the tower.
Ugh. Fine.
The elevator.
Of course. Of course.
Considering how long Arkham's been here, this place is pretty solid.
Well, I mean, it had that Wayne money. A vacuum tube radio manufactured in 1947. Arlene Quinzel, psychiatrist.
Harley's office. She was an incredible doctor. Until she wasn't.
Cat calendar, a gift from former patient Selena Kyle. Canonically, Selena Kyle never went to Arkham. She was a Blackgate prisoner. Clown painting, a painting intended to make Dr. Quinzel's office more inviting. Yeah, no, that tracks for Harley. Oh, I didn't look to see whose office this was. Jeremiah Arkham. The director. Psychiatry book. Several books, many written by Dr. Hugo Strange. Dr. Hugo Strange. Among the collection of psychiatric research and reference books are The Dying Mind, Mind Readers, and the highly controversial Witnesser, all semi-reputable works authored by Arkham's own Hugo Strange. Hugo Strange, speaking of. Oh, look, a hole in his wall.
I can reach the tower from down here.
Wow, they gave him a shit office. Don't blame them. He was a pretty shit person. Hold on a second. Nope, can't get up there? Okay. Why do I feel like this is a bad idea? That amplifier frequency.
Changing the frequency might help explain what was going on here.
Okay, hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you're 1, then you need to be that. 2 is that. Oh, wait. Oh, Jesus. All right. Is this a wire puzzle? Okay, green. here. Ah, I see. All right, so this one needs to match that. Needs to be.
That makes sense.
Next one is blue, which is this one. Needs to look like. Yep. Oops. Come on, give me it back. All right. Red comes over here, and it's the red one. And this one is. Oh, womp. Okay.
There we go.
Oh, I have to do it in a specific order. I see. Okay. So this one is one, and that one matches, I think, the blue cable. Yes, blue cable, which goes here. So we have to do this one first. Come on. Or do I have to reset it first? All right. All right, next is this one. All right. Next is red one. And then finally, there we go. Group M.
They were using this to run sonic tests on the volunteers to control them. That can't be good.
No, it can't.
Belfry here. We've run the data.
And it shows Talia found a Lazarus pit that she's been using to supercharge what Langstrom started.
Precisely, but where is the Lazarus pit?
Under Arkham.
Mountain timeline. Somewhere under Gotham.
Probably in that fucking, I don't know. Down where the Dionysium is. Hey, look, it's the man bat.
Easy does it. Let's not make this into a fight, okay?
I I was playing nice. Ow. I'm glad I did all the reds first. Kind of fitting that it's Barbara. Kinda. Vaguely.
Scans show your back is not injured. Bruised, but nothing more.
Chaos. That's why it's fitting.
City tonight after another vicious attack in Robinson Park. There are reports across the city of flying creatures wreaking havoc. Police are urging citizens to stay calm and remain indoors.
I'm going back out there.
The others are already on patrol. Once you are ready...
I'm ready. When I was injured, everyone expected me to quit.
You weren't inches injured, Barbara. You were paralyzed.
That's never gonna happen. Protecting people runs in my veins. It's what I do. No matter what alias I go by, that's who I am. That's who I'll always be. As long as there are people who need me.
I'm certain you already know what must be done.
There's a Lazarus pit somewhere in Gotham. Wherever it is, Talia and her league won't be far. Time to put an end to this.
You could show us what it said, game.
New data was added to the board.
Get off the geometry.
I'm live on location at a sighting of the strange creatures plaguing Gotham. Police urging citizens to remain indoors until they've identified.
Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. Because I'm a nerd and I need to know. I need to know. Say, code black. Thanks, Alfred. All right, I have to run to the bathroom, so I'm gonna do that. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere, y'all. we're back. Mouse, there you are. All right, before we do that, let's see. Did I get anything of note? I got a better. Come on. Oh, right. I don't have enough materials to craft legendary shit anyway. All right. Question, Lucius. Oh, okay. So it just says four legendary chips to create a legendary mod chip. Okay. All right. Well, let's give that a try. It's home button. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4. What does that do? Okay. Interesting. Huh. Okay. That's only one I needed, right? Or is it two that I needed? Do I need it? Okay. All right. Profiles. And bats. All right. So instead of actually, hold on, what's the level? 24, 25? All right, what I'm thinking is we'll go for the clay faces thing, and that probably will wrap us up. Probably. All right, will it let me swap? It will, okay.
Reports of screeching sounds and strange lights have many Gothamites asking, what's going on?
Any emails? No. Excuse me.
Staff conduct and treatment of inmates. The asylum held many of Gotham's worst offenders, including former district attorney Harvey Dent and wrestler Wayne Jones, better known as Killer Croc. Arkham's inmate population was largely transferred to Blackgate Penitentiary, where similar complaints are only compounded by issues with unsanitary conditions and overcrowding. This is GCN. I'm Noor Rashid.
All right, case files, Clayface, Rumble at the Reservoir. Let's go. We'll go in as Babs.
Grabbing them would take way too long.
Hey, maybe we could use this one as bait.
Oh?
This is going nowhere.
Did you break something again?
Huh. Looks like they're headed north now.
Tim, the clay's moving.
It does that sometimes. It's fine.
Tim?
Shit! Tim, it went down the drain.
Why didn't you warn me?
I did.
We did.
Totally did.
Guys, get over here. Every piece of clayface in town is headed for the reservoir.
Great. Then we can take them all out at once.
You saw what happened. If they blocked the pipes like they did here, it would build a lot of pressure.
If the dam burst, it would flood North Gotham. We wouldn't have time to evacuate.
I'll call Montoya and let her know what's going on.
Shit.
it. Where'd you come from?
Right in front of you, actually.
Commissioner King's been calling me nonstop. The whole city's out of water. She wants this fixed ASAP.
Then I better get going. Any citizens still inside?
Most of the night crew left after they saw mud going up the pipes, but some are still evacuating. You should have the place to yourself soon enough.
Lucky me.
Better you than me. Now get going, before my backup gets here.
Belfry, I'm in. No sign of Clayface yet.
He invited us to his premiere. This has got to be a trap.
It looks like semen. Again. Dumbass. That was too easy. Yeah.
We're good here, Belfry.
No, we're not.
We're still detecting something. Readings are spiking. You must evacuate now. I'm sending the bat cycle to your location.
Did you really think it would be that easy?
Free.
Ow. Damn it. Shit. There we go. Now he looks more like Clayface.
Bring it on, tough guy.
You shouldn't have underestimated me.
I don't. Jesus.
Just like squishing ants.
Come on, girl. There you go.
Looks like you had some fun.
As much fun as you're gonna have writing the report for all this.
Just another day at the office. Stopping a clay monster from drowning the city isn't the weirdest thing I've ever done.
That's Gotham for you. Keeps you on your toes.
And busy. The commissioner wants me to bag and tag each piece of clay individually.
Thank you for that.
She really doesn't like you, huh?
That's the understatement of the year. I swear, if you spandex people weren't so useful, I... Why do I even bother?
Citizens to remain indoors until they've identified. Wait, what's that? It seems to be gone now. Back to our report.
Talia used Langstrom's research to create man bats, flying creatures she controls through sonic frequencies. There's no way to know how many man bats Talia has under her control. The whole city will be in danger unless we stop them. While we were in Arkham, we found water that originates from what seems to be a Lazarus pit here in Gotham City. If Talia does have access to one, she will be unstoppable. We have to find the pit and destroy it. Man-bats are terrorizing the city and attacking citizens. They've been sighted in three locations. Elliott Center, Wayne Tech, and Gotham City General Hospital.
Case closed.
All right. Play Burner Tonfa, lol. Hold on, let's pop in. No, that's not. An owl's nest, some other stuff. One second. Just 1 second. Sorry, I've got some stuff over here that's needing my attention. Okay. Okay. Anyway. We were going out to Gotham. Well, I wanted to check this first. Clayface Showdown, Harley Quinn Showdown, Freeze Showdown, Mr. Freeze Showdown. All right. Okay.
While you handle the man bats, we'll work on locating the source of the signal controlling them.
Oh, damn. Okay. Well, oh, shoot. Hi.
Appreciate it.
I'm gonna go give that time trial a shot. All right.
Bring it.
Breath.
Got it.
Girl, I swear to Christ.
Hell yeah.
Barely. By the skin of my nose. Ugh. Okay. Alright, alright, alright.
I don't know what they're thinking.
Damn it. Hey, look, you hit me. Okay. At 80.
Hey.
What's up?
I appreciate your help.
Good.
You should.
Thank you. I'll let her run. Oh, wrong button. Alright, to the right I go. No. Don't
just getting started.
I'm glad you showed up when you did.
Just remember that we're on the same side.
Okay. Oh, wrong button. Alright, I'm gonna go talk to Toshio. And then I'll call it a night. Cause it is almost 10. I didn't mean to do that. There we go.
Till next time.
All right, so that's it for me for the night. It's a couple minutes before 10, but it's close enough, you know. So, thanks for tuning in. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for spending the time with me while I continue my way through this game. I will assuming all things constant, I'll have her final ability back ready and all that type of shit. Next time, and until then, you should absolutely check out these amazing people I have listed up here. I have even more recommendations in that link tree below. And speaking of that link tree, as I said at the top of the stream, you should, if you want to find me at other locations like my YouTube where I put up my VODs, or my socials where you want updates, my Discord, etc. That's all in there. But it's also in there is my Patreon, where you can choose to support me if you so want, if you're able and willing. You could support me in my Patreon. It's only one or two bucks a month, just a little bit to help make sure that I'm able to continue to do this on a regular basis and help improve things at least a little bit. So yeah, but it's all, you know, optional. I won't hold it against you if you don't. Anyway, that's it for me for the week. We should be back again, all things constant. Watch my socials and my Discord for updates. But all things constant, we should be back on Monday with more Assassin's Creed. Until then, remember to have empathy, be kind, be safe, love yourselves and love everyone around you, and I'll see you all next time. I love you all. Peace out.